This video is presented to you by www.testprepadda.com. The next question says, a railroad curve is to be laid out on a circle. What radius should be used if the track is to change the direction by 25 degree in a distance of 40 meters. So consider this as the center. Radius is R and arc of 40 meters. This angle is given as 25 degree. So first we will convert this 25 degree into radian angle. How? We know that pi radian is 180 degree. So 25 degree will become pi by 180 into 25. Okay, now we know arc length is equal to theta, that is angle in radian, into radius. Arc length is given as 40. Radius we have to find. Angle is 25 upon 180 and pi I'll write 22 by 7. Now if I solve, I get this R as 91.719 meter. So the question is, a railroad curve is to laid out on a circle. What radius? 91.719 meters should be used if the track is to change the direction by 25 degree in a distance of 40 meters. Okay. Now I'll take another question here. Now the question says, if the arcs of the same length in two circles subtend angles 55 degree and 110 degrees at the center, find the ratios of their radii. Arc length of the two circles same. So if I take two circles, one of radius R1, one of radius R2. It says the arc length is same. Arc length is same. In one case, the angle is given as 55 degree. And in the another case, the angle is given as 110. So if I take this as 55 degree and this as 110, this arc length, the two are same. First of all, angle should be in radian. So 55 degree will be converted into radian. How? 55 into pi by 180, this radian, theta 1. Now similarly, 110 degree will be converted into radian. How? 110 into pi by 180 radian. This has theta 2. Now use the formula, arc length is equal to theta in radian into R. Now for the two circles, the arc length same. That is why you can say theta 1 into r1 is equal to theta 2 into r2. And that is why r1 upon r2 will become theta 2 upon theta 1. Now, if I substitute these values here, it comes pi by 180, pi by 180 will get cancelled. So, at the end, it will be 110 upon 55. And that comes 2 by 1. That is why the ratio of the radii will be what? 2 is to 1. Okay. Now, I'll take another question here. This is a very good question. Question says, for each natural number k, let the ck denotes the circle with radius k centimeters and the center at the origin. On the circle ck, a particle moves k centimeters in counterclockwise direction. After completion, the spelling error is there. After completing its motion on CK, the particle moves to CK plus 1 in the radial direction. The motion of the particle continues in this manner. The particle starts at 1 comma 0 and the particle crosses the positive direction of x axis for the first time on the circle CN. Nth circle, then the value of n is. So take this positive x, negative x, positive y, negative y. Now it says starts with 1 comma 0. If I take it as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on. So this way, this is the first circle of radius 1 centimeter. This is another circle. This is another circle. This is another circle. Now, what is given the question? It says the particle starts from here, 1, 1, 0. The particle moves k centimeters. So here, since it starts with at 1 comma 0, it will move how many centimeters? 1 centimeter. Okay, 1 centimeter. And since the radius is 1 centimeter, this will also be 1 centimeter. This is 1 centimeter. After completing 1 centimeter, it says on CK, the particle moves to CK plus 1. That means now it will move to the circle of radius 2 centimeter. And how does this move? In the radial direction. This is the way it moves from this circle to this circle. And now in the second circle, which is of radius 2 centimeter, the particle moves 2 centimeter. Okay, 2 centimeter. Now again it moves from the second to third in the same manner, radial direction. Now it will move how many centimeters? 3 centimeters. Right, now it will continue. Now in the fourth circle, again it will move to 4 centimeters, and then fifth circle, and then sixth, like this way. Now what you can analyze here, in this first circle the arc length was 1 centimeter, radius is 1 centimeter. So what angle it will make in the first circle? 1 radian. Now when it moves to second circle, when it moves to second circle, it moves 2 centimeter. Radius is 2 centimeter, radius is 2 centimeter, arc length is 2 centimeter, and that is why the angle will be 1 radian. The definition of 1 radian, the definition of 1 radian is what? The angle subtended by the arc of length equal to the radius. So as per the definition of 1 radian, on every circle during its motion it will subtend an angle of 1 radian. That says after CN the particle crosses for positive direction of x-axis. So if I add 1 radian, 1 radian, 1 radian, how many circles? N circles. What will be the total angle made here? N radian. N radian. And since on nth circle it crosses the positive x direction, N radian must be greater than, what is this total one round angle? 2 pi. Must be greater than 2 pi. 2 pi, or you say 360 degrees. Since here we are saying 1 radian, 1 radian. It is radian angle, so we have to say 2 pi. So N radian will be greater than 2 pi. Now if I substitute the value of pi as 22/7, this comes approximately 6.28. Now n must be an integer, and that is why the value of n must be what? 7. So the question says we have to find the n. The motion of the particle continues in this manner. The particle starts at 1, 0. If the particle crosses the positive direction of x-axis for the first time on the circle n, then n. So, 7th circle. Right answer is 7th circle. Dear students, in the next session of trigonometry, we will talk about the trigonometric identities, basic identities and trigonometric ratios. Okay, thank you. This video is presented to you by www.testprepadda.com. Testprepadda.com provides free audio-visual lectures of different subjects by expert faculties, free online tests prepared by expert faculties to students who are preparing for engineering or medical entrance exams or planning to take exams like KVPY, Olympiad, etc. It provides a platform where students can interact with mentors to improve their performance in the exams. The mission of this online medium is to help students to achieve their goals. Log on to www.testprepadda.com to watch free video lectures on different topics, to download free revision notes, to take free chapter-wise online tests, progressive test and mock test, to discuss doubts with mentors. Thank you for watching the video. To stay up to date with the latest videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Like us on our Facebook page, Test Prep Adda. All the best.